A new law giving students the ability to express their religion any way they want is now in effect. It's for both public and private schools. And for years, public schools have maintained a separation between school and state. But that is about to change. Parents and students say not being allowed to express themselves or their religion is violating a part of their First Amendment right. And now students have the freedom to express what they want starting this school year. So is this going to be a problem? We're going to bring in attorney Dane Heppner to answer some of our questions. And good morning to you, Dane. We always love having you.
Good morning.
Ooh, what a controversial topic. Yeah. And I guess the issue here is, how do you prioritize the separation of church and state over the constitutional provision of freedom of religion?
Right. So what we are talking about is the First Amendment is the Establishment Clause. It says that there's a separation between church and state, that we won't establish a particular religion. In the same breath, it also gives us the right to express our own religious beliefs. And so now what the Florida legislature has done, there's a whole body of case law throughout the years that have kind of defined, what does that mean? What does the First Amendment mean? And the Florida legislature has attempted to interpret those years of case law and put it in a statute form and say, well, hey, students should be allowed to attend school, express their religious beliefs in classwork, and not be penalized for it, so long as it's kind of within the course curriculum. And similarly, they should be allowed to have religious organizations and teachers sponsor those religious organizations after school hours and things like that.
Okay, so let's talk about that, because you say after school hours, not within the school day.
Right.
Is that correct?
Yeah, so it can't be mandatory. You can't force anybody to participate, like before class, everyone stand up and say the Lord's Prayer or something like that. It has to be voluntary. So after hours, you can have groups get together, and regardless of the religious belief, they should have the same access to the public facilities as any other secular, non-religious organization.
Okay, so does this negate the concern over the teaching of, say, for instance, evolution and intelligent design?
Right.
Okay.
So there is a little bit of a concern now that because we've gone the extra step and sort of codified it and kind of maybe taken a little bit of a superfluous step and putting it in statute form, that it might embolden some teachers to say, well, now I've got religious freedom in the classroom. And so even though the curriculum says that we're going to be learning about Darwin's origin of the species via natural selection, I'm going to teach creationism instead. And the statute expressly says that you can practice these religious beliefs, you can have these after-school organizations, so long as it doesn't interfere with adhering to the course curriculum and completing your teacher duties, your teacher responsibilities.
Okay, so let's expand upon that a little bit, because we've reported in the past the story of the football team that wanted to pray before the game.
Sure.
And the coach was behind it, and the students all wanted it.
Sure.
Even the parents, everybody was on board saying, we want to pray. Does this change any of that? Will they now be able to pray?
Well,
because it's an after-school activity.
Right, but there's sort of a feeling there that it's mandatory. If the whole team is kind of gathering together before they take the field and saying the Lord's Prayer or any prayer,
okay.
There's kind of this it's a mandatory thing that, hey, Dane, if you don't participate, you're not going to be the starting quarterback tonight, which you wouldn't want me as the starting quarterback anyways. But, you know, that's kind of the background there.
Listen, Dane, it's okay. I wouldn't want you as part of my legal counsel. That's really all that matters at the end
that's
of the
right.
day. One of the legal experts said, you know, I feel sorry for the attorneys for the school boards, that they're going to have to deal with this. It's sort of like you said, there was a looser interpretation of the law before. Now, in an attempt to protect that, the language they've used is so specific, it allows for more legal recourse, or no?
Well, the reason it allows for more legal recourse is because now that it's codified, if parents think that maybe their student got a bad grade on a test because they expressed their religious belief, or that they're being prohibited from expressing themselves, either through the clothes that they wear, or jewelry, or even just participating after school programs, the parents can have an attorney represent them, maybe file against the school board to have some sort of injunction issued, and the attorneys are going to be willing to do it because there's also a little provision carved out in the statute that if you're successful in getting that injunction, you get attorney's fees. So the attorneys are going to say, yeah, we'll sign you up and fight for you. Because if we win, I get paid.
So you raise an important issue, too, with the teachers. I mean, let's say, for instance, in the science classes, evolution, I mean, how do you interpret, how does it protect the teachers? You said in the classroom, but again, you go back to no person is prohibited the right to express their religious belief.
Right. So it has to, again, it just has to stay within the course curriculum. So
okay.
The curriculums aren't changing.
That's already set.
They're going to have to teach the theory of evolution. Now, it doesn't mean that you have to believe in it, but for purposes of complying with the curriculum, you have to teach it and you have to kind of stick to it. You can't just disregard it and say, well, I believe this, so therefore I'm not going to teach these things.
All right. Thank you. Always provide a little more clarity on the matter. Dane Hepner, thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
Don't forget, it's Ask a Lawyer Day. Free legal questions answered today. Let's get over to Charlie Belcher with a look at what he's up to. It's all fun for you.